Hi guys, welcome back to BPrep. In this video, we are going to solve a Venn diagram related question which was asked in one of the CAT paper. I'm gonna show you how you can quickly use the formula to get the answer, and in case you are facing difficulty in memorizing the formula or interested in how to get the formula, then I'll also explain that. Let's jump to the question. "50 college teachers are surveyed as to their possession of color TV, VCR and tape recorder. Of them, 22 own color TV, 15 own VCR and 14 own tape recorders. 9 of these college teachers own exactly 2 items out of color TV, VCR and tape recorder. And 1 college teacher owns all 3. So, this is a very clear case of Venn diagram where we have 3 items. So, let's name them A, B and C. Or anything for that matter. So this is A, B and C. Okay. A is 22, B is 15 and C is 14. Okay. And those who own exactly 2 items, the sum is given as 9. So here we can say it's P, Q and R. The sum of P, Q, R is given as 9. And teachers who own exactly 3 items is 1. So this is the case given here. And if you know the formula, you can get the answer within seconds. So in question, it is being asked that how many of the 50 teachers own none of the 3, color TV, VCR or tape recorder. So this is very clear. If we want to find out the value of none, that means teachers who do not own anything, then that can be simply get from total number of teachers minus those who own at least 1 item. Okay. So this is very clear. Okay. So total is given as 50. There are 50 teachers, and those who own at least 1 item is A, Union B, Union C. Okay. If you know the formula, you can directly put it here. So 50 minus A union B union C will be 22 plus 15 plus 14 minus 9 minus 2 into 1. So 2 into 1. This will be 50 minus 51 minus 11. Okay. Or this is 50 minus 40. So this is 10. So answer of this question will be 10. So there are 10 teachers who does not own anything. But in case if you are facing difficulty, I think the problematic part for you could be here. So how we are getting this A union B union C to this. Okay. So to understand this part, I'll explain you. So let's remove 1 for now. And let it be G. Okay, so we have given it as G. So this A union B union C is nothing but this union of A, B, C is indicates that out of A, B and C, whatever guys are appearing in these 3 groups, we need to count them just once. So even if people are coming twice or thrice, we need to count them just once. Okay. That is the meaning of A union B union C. So here, if you see A union B union C, if you try to figure out from this diagram, what they will be is simply A plus B plus C. So now if you see in the diagram, if we add A and B, let's forget about C for this moment. So if we add A and B, P is getting added twice in A as well as in B. And in the union of these 3, we need to count them just once. We cannot count them twice. So we need to remove or we need to subtract P once. So if I say P is getting added in A as well as in B, okay, twice. Similarly, Q is also getting added in A as well as in C. And if you see R, R is getting added in B as well as in C. So this PQR is getting added twice. So while we are adding A, B and C, these three are also getting added twice. So we need to remove their one occurrence. So to remove their one occurrence, we can simply subtract P plus Q plus R from ABC. Okay, good so far. And now if you see G, which is in center, is getting counted in A, B, C, both, like all three. So this G is getting counted in A as well as in B as well as in C. So when we are adding A, B, C, G is getting added thrice. So when this is getting added thrice, we need to remove two occurrence of G. Okay, so from this expression, we need to remove 2G. Okay, so if you remove 2G, just one occurrence will get counted. So now from ABC, if we subtract this, then it's getting a union of ABC again. That means we are counting one person. Okay, no matter in which all group they are appearing. So union of ABC should be clear now. So now if you see, when we were using the direct formula, this 2 into 1 is nothing, but it came from here. Okay, 9, it came from here. It was already given in the question that people who own exactly 2 items is 9. So PQR is the sum of those people who own exactly 2 items. Okay, this is also clear in the diagram. So this 9 came from here, and this 12 plus 15 plus 14 came from here. Okay, so I hope this should be clear now. If you have any questions or doubts, please post in comments. And guys, please do subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to get notification about the latest videos. Thank you for watching this video.